Okay, welcome back, and hopefully I've got my mic sorted. I just need to do a AV check. I think I've tested as best I can, but the only proof is in the pudding, so to speak. Excuse me. Okay. Da, da, da. So hopefully you can hear me 5x5. And we're going to give this another go to get going. Okay. There's some control panel. We'll unlock that window. Go to our overhead. So just an idea, this is a startup, so this is PAX temperature cargo area control. This is pressurization. I'm going to set it at about 800. Let's set it to 8,000. I'm not going to turn it on until we're past 10,000. That'd be good enough for government work. Put our lights on. Get the. Just give us a sec. Put the lower overhead on. Test, that's all good. Dump valves are closed. Fuel looks good. Okay, hydraulics panel. Is set. Condition levers. Speed idle control set. Okay, let's go and check our radios on. Check our 80s. So we just get Active Sky loaded again. Hopefully got the mics set up, so anyone watching, please let me know if you can hear voice 5x5. I've got a new headset and decimal 8 for that. Close that down. There are very few navigational aids this far south. Okay, so we're ready, I think, to start up the GPU. Or gas turbine, rather. Okay, if anyone was watching earlier, I do apologise. The system shut down. I was had a few mic issues that I was trying to sort out. GTU fired up. Okay, switch up to main power. Battery's taken over. External tanks are on. Drain them down first. Right planet. So, we don't need that. So we're going to... It's not Pegasus Field anymore. Oh god, I can't remember what name. There we go. Shall we do the overhead when we get there? So I'm going to be cruising at 25,000. Departure time is, we'll say 18:45. Flight plan is filed. Stops in the air. Okay, ready to start 3. Three's turning. Two's turning. wing heat on, nacelle heat off. Set. Landing lights on. Throttle's up. Speed to live. V1, V2, rotate. Positive rate gear up. Laps 5. Overfly of the base. Flaps up. climb Concord Field. Or Concordia. Like at 10,000 feet. Okay, climb, so check, throttle set, flaps are up, gear is up and indicated. Landing, taxi lights off, strobes are on, nav lights are on. Heat's on. There we go. And that's how we do that. Tuning in. We're currently flying back to, well, it used to be called Pegasus Field, and that's all I know it by.
Phoenix Field. Go. Cruise checklist. Lights are off. Pressurization set. Sorted. Outbound. Just jump back in. I just found something out that I got the autopilot Logitech, or formerly Satex autopilot module, and it actually works with the Herc, so you can actually set vertical speed and altitude, and it'll fly to it. which is Dabandi. So when you're doing step climbs, normally it's very manual. And this old bird, the real aircraft, obviously being updated with the new FMCs. So thanks for tuning in. We're now at our cruise of 25,000 over the Antarctic. It's returning from AQ30, completing our ATO, and we'll pick up another one and get that done. Fire up that spy. Have a look. Fuel. There we go. And it's taking its time. Okay, so that's us, gear 3-5, then we've got reach 3520, it's one of our guys coming out of Pegasus, and that's where we're relocating back to. McMurdo's just about closing now, or would normally close at this time of year, end of December, with Pegasus opening up in January for the winter, our winter, for summer, because the runway melts. Go further onto the ice shelf. Okay. Let's have a look outside. So we've got the external tanks on first, that'll lower the stress on the airframe. There's our lovely little aircraft. So hope everyone's had a good new year. Now we're getting into obviously into January. Just go and try do an altitude change. This might go horribly wrong and it might crash. But using the Logitech autopilot. Bugger me, silly. It works. Now, it might be too much to ask for the... So if I go back up to 25... Phoenix Field as it is now. Minus two. Okay. 0.30 at 9 knots. Scattered 11,000. Broken, Dean. 29019. So unlike the rest of the world, it is extremely white. There's the clouds. Oh, let's see if we can get up to 27. Over this. Let's get up. Simca 2.9. Long old flight. Well, not that long. Herc flights normally are a bit longer. Okay, let's go and get Plan G fired up and we'll get the VOR at Pegasus on our NAV 1 radio. As we get closer, we can go and check our ground speed. At the top of our ceiling now. Thank you for tuning in. We're currently taking empties back from AQ30 in Antarctica back to Phoenix Field, as it's called now, not Pegasus. Discord. Having a chill flight back, just keep an eye on our fuel, engines, T's and P's, temperatures and pressures. Wow. PS3. So we'll have on nav 2. Station. It's probably going to be one of the few places we'll be able to get in. Speed's 315 knots, which is pretty good. Still got 400 miles nautical left to run. Talking randomly for about 5 seconds as B pilot calibrates the mic. Skier 35, radio check, over. Skier 35, radio check.
Skier 35, radio check, over.
that's a hell of a lot clearer. This Thrustmaster headset is not bad at all. So it's all going in. Got quite an Airbus. So if you want to chill out, sit back, relax, if you want to ask, I've got any questions on two live streams. How does two live streams work? That's a new one on me. How that works. Flight Choppers are getting on with his IFR rating. Looks like There you go, just go to sleep with the sound of the Allison. These are the Allison T56, not the Rolls-Royce engines. Top-man burner. Sorting out some stuff for me. For our A-car system. Less than an hour. we are smoking along. Back in the cockpit. We'll start our pre-descent checks. Drop out of the internet then. So this is the mad thing about this far south, is we're actually heading in an easterly direction, and if we have a look at the compass, there we go, we're heading west. Yeah, so magnetic matches up. Why your GPS is pretty damn handy. Tuning in. Far off our top of descent. Probably about half an hour. What I'm really chuffed with is the I got the Logitech, formerly Satech, autopilot panel. And that's that works pretty well with the C-130, which is just basically, in this model, it's got altitude hold, but we can actually almost get some semblance of a rudimentary FMC, so we can sort of plan our descents and descent rates without focusing really on hand flying and just chilling out. Developer of Plan G will be able to put in tops of climb and top of descent. very careful because it's a mountain range. To the west. If anybody watching this thinks you want to have a go or interested in military flying, you can always check out the VUSAF website. regulator. Rate of descent, cruise altitude, we are at 29,000. Field elevation is zero. Indicator SB230, that's not ground speed. Distance from target, we are 223. Get closer. See if I do 90 miles. I think we can get a lot closer than that. Oh, can't quite go to 50, I think about. We get 80 miles out. Descent, we want about 1800. So, how close? 67.1 nautical miles is our TOD. Range of the Phoenix field. Okay, we're not far off. We're going to get to 67.1 nautical miles, then we're going to do a 1800 foot rate of descent down into was Pegasus, now Phoenix Field. It's a bit of a flight test. New headphones and mic. So thanks for tuning in. So got a few things to test out. Our Logitech autopilot module, our radios, nautical, so we're going to get into 61, get over the mountains. Solid now for nearly an hour and 40, and we're going to start very shortly in about 100 nautical miles our descent. So that should be in about 10 minutes. So 67.1 nautical miles will start our descent. Really good model. I just push Captain Sim and update it and give us a proper J cockpit, sort of. But Milvis, hopefully, they're bringing theirs out. See what happens. But yeah, Captain Sim, to be fair, I think this is not bad. Obviously, it's not PMDG, but it's a solid model, well representative of a C-130, and I spent, well, my first Herc flight was in 1991, and my last was in 2000, this one 2003, with basically 3 years in that, 98 to about 95 to 98 in the back of them. about as close as I've ever come to starting the descent. I mean, close to the airfield, though, we're stepping down quite a way back. But we've got a mountain range that we're scooting over under those clouds. We don't want to fly into them. So I want to get over to the Ross Inlet. Before we're hitting Ross Island. SS sound pack for the Herc. Which is pretty good. It's definitely worth it. Got a descent calculator, then we've calculated at 67.1 nautical for our descent, and we're going to stick to that because we're going to see how accurate it is. going to have a look at setting what the time is from Bird to Pegasus. Phoenix, as it's called now. Thank you. checks crew briefing. So we're going to send 2,000 on approach to Pegasus. We're going to do turn on the wind direction. We'll overfly the runway, do a right hand brake, and go on descent. Minimum, so we'll descend to 300. If we don't see the runway, then we'll climb and divert to. NZWD navigation aids. I've got navigation NDBs tuned in, BORs are tuned in. Okay, go below 2000 over restricted areas, and we'll get the passengers strapped in and sat down in the cabin. Secure. Landing data checked. Done the winds. 030 at 9 knots. Climb broken. Radar altimeter, we'll set up at 300. Bolt shield harness fastened and unlocked. Radar altimeter set as required. Altimeter set and checked. 2919. Let's have a look. Thank you. Oh, there we go. VOR's just come on. Get down below the cloud before we get too close to Pegasus and see the runway on approach. We're just checking the our ground speed's 270. In line with the VOR. Got ice cracks on the Ross ice shelf, which is why we have to move. Broken at 17. perhaps one. West, I'm just flown in the same direction. Or is that? No, that's where. Pegasus. Williamsfield is over here. Ah, Williamsfield's over there. Oh, thanks, mate. Landing checks. Altimeter set to 2919 flaps. 25 landing gear down. Hydraulic panel set. Oxide pump on. Hydraulic pressures checked. Landing checks complete. Okay, so Pegasus should be off our right. Pressure, eh? It's all white, Captain. Pegasus VOR isn't where Pegasus Field is. how bad this could be. Where the chuff is that runway? Another pan on the left.
automatic.
Alan, we have to turn that off. Just call me Iceman, I just like flying around in ice. Ready or not.
Don't sink. 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 Don't sink.
Mystery tour. That was it. We're lined in, ready, coming on, coming ready or not. Text lights on, land lights off, strobes off. Computer heat's off. Landing at Phoenix, formerly Pegasus. And that is that. Thanks for watching. Any questions, if you want to have a look at the VUSAF website, check it out. And thanks for watching Operation Deep Freeze. More to come.